everyone, welcome to Electronics Gateway. In this video lecture, we'll talk about serial communication basics using ATmega 16 microcontroller. So, as we have seen in the previous tutorial, that what is the meaning of serial communication and some basics about that. So, in this video lecture, we'll basically see how this serial communication can be done using ATmega 16 microcontroller. So, we have already seen in the previous tutorial that serial communication can be done in two ways, that is synchronous and asynchronous way. So, this synchronous and asynchronous data communication can be done by writing software in a microcontroller or a microprocessor or a computer, but the process is very tedious and complicated. Therefore, what the manufacturer did in order to simplify this entire process, they have inbuilt some special ICs for doing serial communication that are also known as UART chip inside the microcontroller. So we have already studied these UART chips or UART chips while studying 8085 microprocessor or 8086 microprocessor. There we basically use a chip known as 8251 UART chip for doing serial communication. In the same way, the same hardware is present inside the microcontroller's IC also. So there are many families of microcontroller that are available in the market, in which those ICs have inbuilt UART hardware. So among those families, some of them are 8051 family, PIC family, and ARM controller family. In the same way, AVR family also have inbuilt UART hardware. So now in the previous tutorial, we have already seen that for doing serial communication, that is asynchronous communication, data has to be sent in the form of frames. So in this, in that frame, the starting bit is known as start bit, is represented by a low voltage level, followed by some data bits. The standard data bits are 8 in number and followed by stop bits. So there the stop bits can be 1 or 2. Now, as we have seen that if we want to send a data frame using UART communication, then in a frame, 8 bits are information or data bits and 2 bits are redundant bits. That means they don't carry any information. So if we calculate the overhead bits, then it will be, here you see that in this frame, 2 bits are redundant bit. That means start bit. If you consider only one stop bit, so it becomes 1 plus 1, 2. So 2 divided by 8 multiplied by 100. So 2 is the redundant bit divided by 8, which is the data bit, multiplied by 100, it will be 25%. This means that if we send data frame using UART communication, then the overhead, then the percentage overhead bits is 25%. And this is the standard overhead percentage for each UART communication. Now, as you can see here, there are two types of packages available in the market for ATmega 16 or 32 or ATmega 8 microcontroller. So, first one is known as TDIP package, dual inline package, and the second one is known as TQFP package, that is thin quad flat package. So, here you see that in DIP package, pin number 14 and 15 are the UART pin. Therefore, the output of the inbuilt UART hardware is connected at pin number 14 and 15. So, this pin number 14 and 15 is basically the pins of D0 and D1 is the pins of D port. And it basically represents the UART port. So in the same way, if you see TQFP package, pin number 9 and 10, which also belongs to D port. So basically represents UART port. So how we have to do connection by wiring connection while we perform UART communication. So suppose we have two devices, that is device 1 and device 2. So device 1 can be a microcontroller, device 2 can be again a microcontroller, or it can be some digital sensor, or it can be some another peripheral device. So what we have to do, we have to connect that transmitter pin, TX pin of first device, that is microcontroller, with the RX pin of the second device, and we have to connect the RX pin of first device with the TX pin of second device. But while doing this entire process, we should keep in our mind that the ground should be common. If you don't do if you don't make a common ground, then your data will not be transferred from first device to second or second to first. So this thing should be noted, that the ground between these two devices must be common. So if we talk about AVR family of microcontrollers, that is, it may be ATmega 8, ATmega 16, ATmega 32, ATmega 328. You talk about any microcontroller inside this family. So in order to do UART communication, we have to deal with these five registers. First one is known as UBRR, UART baud rate register. Second one is UDR, UART data register. Third one is UCSRA, UART controller and status register A, UART control and status register B, and UART control and status register C. We have to deal with these five registers. So we will talk about these things later on in details. So now the question arises that if we do serial communication, then what is the meaning of baud rate? So the meaning of baud rate is, can be defined as, it is the number of information bits per sample or per frame per second. So this means that the number of information bits per sample per second is known as baud rate, and however it is measured in bits per second. So the number of information bits per sample per frame per second, the number of information bits per sample or per frame per second is known as baud rate, and it is measured in bits per seconds. Now here, for example, we see that if we assume that 10 frames are sent per second, then we'll calculate that what is the baud rate of it. So among these, as we already know that we set 10 frames, so what is there inside the each frame? So we already seen that in each frame there are two redundant bits, that means one start bit, one stop bit, and 8 data bits. So 8 data bits is the standard data bit size. So if we assume that a single frame consists of 8 bits of data and 2 bits, that is start bit and stop bits, so therefore a single frame consists of 10 bits. Now we will see that how many information bits are sent per second. So in a single frame, as we see, in a single frame 8 bits represents information bits. So in 1 second 10 frames are sent, therefore 10 into 8 equals to 80 bits of information are sent per second. And how many number of redundant bits are sent per second? In one frame there are 2 redundant bits, so 2 multiplied by 10, it becomes 20. So 20 is the redundant or overhead bits that are sent per second. So 20 divided by 80 into 100, again it will be 25%. Now we have to ask a question that since the baud rate is measured in bits per second, what is the difference between bit rate and baud rate? So bit rate can be defined as the total number of bits transmitted per second. So in the previous case we have seen that in 1 second 10 frames are sent, each frame is having 10 bits. So how many number of total bits are there? 100 bits. This means that in 1 second 100 bits are transmitted. So 100 bits per second will be the bit rate, and baud rate is 80 bits per second. So always you remember that baud rate is always less than bit rate. So now I hope that the concept is clear up till now and you are happy now. Now we come to baud rate basics. So in any digital system, that may be a computer or a microcontroller, microprocessor or any peripheral device, these are the standard baud rates that are basically used. For example, 1200, 2400, 4800, 9600, you double it, 19200 and up to 115200. These are the standard baud rates that are used for doing UART communication. Now, among these standard baud rates, 4800 baud rate is mostly used for performing serial communication using RF modules. These RF modules may be of 315 MHz or 433 MHz. And this another baud rate, that is 9600, is mostly used for doing PC to PC communication. And this 115200 baud rate is basically used for doing Wi-Fi communication. Okay, now we will come to UART or UART registers that are present in ATmega 16 microcontroller. So the first register is UBRR register. Its meaning is UART baud rate register. So as you can see that this UART baud rate register is a 16-bit register. And among those 16 bits, 12 bits are assigned for UART baud rate value, that is 0 to 11 bits, and 3 bits are not used, and the last bit, that is 15 bit, is known as UR select. Its meaning is UART register selects. So if UART register select, that means UR select value is equals to 0, this means that if we don't assign any value to this particular bit, then whatever be the value of UART, it will be updated in UBRRH, that means UART baud rate register higher byte. And if we assign one value, if we set this bit, that is UR select bit equal to 1, then UCSRC register will be updated. So if we want to do program, if we want to configure UCSRC register, then URSEL bit must be 1. Now here you can see that serial communication can be done in two ways. First, we know that asynchronous way, another one is synchronous way. So asynchronous mode of communication can be done in two modes. One is normal mode, another one is double speed mode. So normal mode or double speed mode will be decided by a bit U2X. So we'll see this U2X later on. Here we see U2X. Here you see that UCSRA register contains this bit, that is U2X. So U2X bit is basically, it is used to decide that whether asynchronous mode of communication is in normal mode or in double speed mode. So if U2X bit is 1, 0, then asynchronous mode is in normal mode, and if U2X bit is 1, then asynchronous operation is in double speed mode. So now we will see that inside the hardware, how UBRR value is calculated. So it depends upon the application that which type or which value of baud rate we require. So suppose that we require 9600 baud rate. So here in this formula, if we are operating in asynchronous operation in normal mode, so in this formula, you write 9600, then you write the oscillator frequency at which you want to operate the microcontroller. Then you can find the value of this UBRR from these two unknown values. So So this is the formula for finding the UBRR value. The UBRR equals to F oscillator divided by 16 times of baud minus 1. So we know F oscillator value, we know baud value, so we can calculate UBRR for normal mode. But if we write U2X equals to 1 in UCSRA register, then the speed will be double. That means that the serial communication will be done at double speed. So here you see the difference in this formula. Here the value is, here the oscillator frequency is now divided by 8. In the previous case it is divided by 16. Since it is divided by 8, so this particular value will be double than that of previous one. So again UBRR can now be calculated as UBRR equals to F oscillator divided by 8 into baud minus 1. And if we are using synchronous mode, so for synchronous mode, the UBRR value can be given as FOSC oscillator frequency divided by 2 multiplied by baud minus 1. So in this tutorial, we will not discuss about synchronous serial communication. We will only focus on asynchronous serial communication. Now assume that the application requires 9600 baud rate and the oscillator frequency is 8 MHz. Then we'll calculate the baud rate by using these two formulas. So assume that the asynchronous mode is in normal mode. So we have to calculate the UBRR value from this first formula. So 8 MHz divided by 16 into 9600 minus 1, it will be 51. So this 51 is in decimal. So if we convert this decimal value into hexadecimal, it will be 33. So this 33 hexadecimal value should be loaded inside this UBRR register. So where it gets updated? It gets updated in UBRL, that is lower byte. Because this 33 or this 51 is less than 255. So it is a 8 bit value. So it will be updated in UBRRL register. This means it will be updated here. So now we'll see the internal hardware, that how this formula is implemented inside the hardware. First you see that oscillator frequency is divided by 16 or it is divided by 8 for asynchronous mode only. So here you see that there is a pre-scaling down counter. It will take the oscillator frequency and it will divide that oscillator frequency. Since it is a down counter, it will divide the oscillator frequency based on this UBRR value. As you can see that F oscillator divided by 16 multiplied by UBRR plus 1. So if you want to divide the oscillator frequency by UBRR plus 1, so you need a down counter. So oscillator frequency divided by UBRR plus 1. Now the output is then passed through a divider circuit, that is divide by 2, divide by 4 and divide by 2 circuit. So now one output is taken from this last divide by 2 circuit and another output is taken from output of divide by 4 circuit, and these two outputs are fed as an input to the MUX 2 cross 1 MUX. So here you see that U2X is the select bit of this MUX. This U2X is 0, this means that the first input will be selected. What will happen is F oscillator divided by UBRR plus 1 will be divided by 2, 2 multiplied by 4, 4 multiplied by 2. This means that this entire formula will be divided by 16. So this means this formula is implemented. Now, if you want to divide it by 8, then you can take the output from this end. So for that you have to select the second line of MUX. So for that U2X should be 1. In that way second input will be selected. So this formula FOSC divided by UBRR plus 1, it will be divided by 8, 2 into 4. Now we come to another important register. Its name is UTR, user data register. Here you see that there are two data register, one for transmitter, another for receiver. So these two data registers are of 8 bit. So one for UDR write, another for UDR read. So this is the internal hardware in order to transmit and receive this serial data. So suppose the data has to be transferred from the microcontroller to some other peripheral using serial communication, then what will happen? The internal parallel data lines of microprocessor will send the data to the transmit buffer. This is a 8-bit buffer. It basically stores the parallel data of microcontroller temporarily, and that data will be shifted to the shift register. In this shift register, frame has to be formed. There the start and stop bit are appended to this serial data, and this serial data is shifted bit by bit to the TXD pin. Now the reverse operation will happen for the receive data. Whatever be the serial receive data is coming through RXD pin, it will be stored in the shift register. From this shift register, start and stop bits are removed. Then this shift, then this 8 bit of data is stored into the receive buffer, and through that it will enter inside the microcontroller. Now the next register is UCSRA, USART Control Status Register A. It is a 8 bit register, and its 7th bit is RXC, USART receive complete. So this bit is set when there is some unread data present in the receive buffer, and it is cleared when the data buffer is empty. This means that if the microcontroller is having some data present in the receive buffer to be read by it, then this particular bit will be automatically set, and it will be automatically reset if the receive buffer is it does not have anything. So next bit is TXC, USART transmit complete. This bit is set when the entire transmit shift register has to be shifted out and no new data is present in the transmit shift register. This means that when the transmitter shift register is empty, it does not have any data to be transmitted further, then this bit will be automatically set, and this bit will be automatically cleared when a transmit complete interrupt is executed. This means that if we the UART communication can be done in two ways. One is known as interrupt driven mode, another one is known as polling mode. So if we are using polling mode, then we have to continuously check the status of this TXC, whether the whether this bit is set or not, because it will indicate that whether the transmit shift register is empty or not. But if we are using interrupt driven method, then if the transmission is not completed, that means the shift register is having some value, this particular TXC bit will be automatically cleared. UDRE, USART data register empty. So this, the name suggests that this particular bit will tell that this particular bit is set when the transmit buffer is empty and it is ready to receive a new data from the controller to transmit. This means that if this particular bit is set, it will tell us that transmitter buffer is empty and it is ready to receive a new data from the controller to transmit. And if it is clear, that means it is already having some data in the buffer and cannot take any other new data to transmit. FE means frame error. This bit is set if there is a frame error in the receiving data. That means there may be a frame, there may be an error in start bit or stop bit or data bits. Next bit is DOR, data overrun. So this bit is set if data overrun is detected. That means if the receive buffer or receive shift buffer is having some data in it and it receives a new start bit of new data frame, then this bit, that is data overrun bit, gets automatically set by the hardware. Parity error, if we set this bit, it will enable the parity checker of the microcontroller. U2X, that is USART double speed mode. If we set this U2X bit, this means that we are selecting the second line, that is second input of the MUX that we have already discussed, so that the UART will operate in double speed. However, if we don't set this particular bit, so by default its value is 0, so by default that UART communication will be done in a normal mode. MPCM is multiprocessor communication mode. So this particular mode will not be discussed in this video lecture, so I am skipping it. Now the next register is UCSRB, UART Control Status Baud register. So this register is very important if we are using UART in interrupt driven mode. So this RXCIE bit, basically its full form is Receive Complete Interrupt Enable. So this bit is set. We have to set this bit in order to enable the Receive Complete flag in UCSRA. And second bit is TXCIE, Transmit Complete Interrupt Enable. This bit is set to enable the TXC flag in that UCSRA register. UDRIE, this means that if we the full form of this UDRIE is UART Data Register Empty Interrupt Enable. So basically this bit is set to enable the UDR, UART Data Register Empty flag in UCSRA. So if we are using interrupt driven mode of UART, then we have to set these three bits in order to enable the Receive Complete, Transmit Complete and UART Data Register Empty Interrupt Enable. And the second one is RXC Enable. So suppose in UART communication we want to use only RX pin of that particular microcontroller, then we have to set this RXEN, or if we want to use only TX pin, then we have to set this pin TXEN, or if we want to use both, then we have to make both as one. Now this UCSZ2, UART character size, this bit is basically used to select the character size of data which has to be embedded or appended in the data frame. So we will talk about this later on when we discuss UCSRB register. And RXB8, so RXB8 means Receive Data Bit 8. So the maximum length of UART data bits is of 9, so it means 0 to 8. So if we are using 9 bit length of data, then that 8th bit means 9th position bit. So this bit has to be set if the number of data bits received is of 9 bit. This means that if we select the number of data bits to be 9 bits, then we have to make or set this RXB8 bit. For using the microcontroller in receive mode, but if we are using in transmit mode, this means if we are want to transmit 9 bit data, then we have to set this TXB8 bit in UCSRB register. Now UCSRC register, UART Control Status Register C. So here we here this UR select means UART register select. This bit selects the access of either UBRRH or UCSRC that we have already discussed in UBRR register. UM select means UART mode select. So basically UART mode select. So UART mode select means either we can select asynchronous mode or we can select synchronous mode. So if UM select bit is set is cleared, then synchronous mode will be selected. If UM select bit is set, then asynchronous mode will be selected. Sorry, actually this is asynchronous. So if UM select bit is 0, then asynchronous mode is selected. If UM select bit is 1, then synchronous mode will be selected. Then UPM, UART parity mode. So there are two parity modes, that is even parity and odd parity. So It depends upon the settings of UPM 0 and UPM 1 that which parity mode will be enabled. If we don't set any bits in these two bits of the register, that is UPM 0 and UPM 1, that means 0, 0, so that parity is disabled. If UPM 0 is 1, then it is reserved for future purpose. If UPM 1 is 1, this means even parity selected. If UPM 1 and UPM 0 both are 1, then odd parity selected. So in the same way, this UB, USBS, USART, stop bit select bit basically selects that whether one stop bit is appended in the frame or two stop bits is appended in the frame. If USBS bit is 0, so one stop bit is appended. If USBS is 1, then two stop bits are appended in the data frame. Now we'll come to USART character size. So there are three bits, UCSZ0, this one, UCSZ1, this one, and UCSZ2, which is present in UCSRB register. So based on the combination of bits in these three in these two registers, character size of the data is basically decided. And we have already discussed that the maximum length is 9. Now the next one is UCPOL, USART clock polarity. So this bit we'll not discuss, as this is basically used for synchronous mode of communication. So now that's all for this video lecture. So in the next video lecture, we'll talk about how to write embedded C code for doing UART communication. Till then, thank you.